The way how Vipassana is practiced in Dzogchen, you know, by people who, like us, who have ways of, you know how to get to the natural state, to that clarity, Dharmakaya clarity, that knowing, is that just like in a two-part formula, you know, you access, you go to that clear knowing, and then when stuff comes up, in 2PF, it's the affirmation, you purposefully bring it up, but now we are talking about not the subject, but other objects appearing in the mind, other stuff in the mind. So when it comes up, you include it. You allow it to be in that same sphere of clarity. You don't push it away, you don't pull it to you, and you don't suppress it. You just include it. And this simple action of including it in the field of awareness, should I put it that way, or which in other words, I often use the phrase of bring the light of awareness into a sense of self, be it in any form, bringing light of awareness to it. So I'll say a little bit about that. So, about this way of observing it, way of being aware of it. So when a bubble comes up, it is important that contact, you know, that the way how you are aware of it, like for example, is this fist represents that impulse, then it's not like a, if it's like this, the contact, there's no really contact. You know, if it's flabby, limp, that's not it. Or this is not it either. Or even if it's more subtle, holding. No. There's just too much already in it. So this is the like the challenge that not flabby, not, but just being present with it. That's what it means. Bring the light of awareness to this, whatever it is. It's sort of like on, when was it? Thursday night in Birmingham, I was speaking about this and gave the same analogy of it, and oh, now the thought disappeared, which is nice. What was I saying? What did I say in Birmingham? Yeah, so good healer or a good masseuse. When you go to that, you sit, you are in the presence of a, you go to some healer or a masseur, and you lie on that table or sit on a chair. And very good healers have that when they put your hands. It's the same kind of contact. You know, that initial connection they make. They create that contact first, and then they can, you know, do whatever they do. But it's the same thing. being present with it. And that can be a bit of a challenge because, you know, if it's our favorite demon, our favorite, you know, self-loathing, anger, anxiety, panic attack, self-pity, you know, pick your favorite. There's endless palette of stuff. So the challenge is really to stay, to trust that leverage the natural state has on any stuff. Because you might be able to, now when we practice in a moment, and I've just been talking about it, we have confidence on this. But then tomorrow, after 2 days, after a week, after a month, you know, okay, I'll just go. You've experienced this already, right? So what then? What do you do then? Get back to the natural state then. Make that basis of our own mind, which is awareness, which is knowing, make that more clear. This is what I say again and again and again in Guidance to Awakening, that you have to have the first mode, selflessness mode, really clear in experience before you can deal with this stuff, before that leverage, before there is the penetrating, like illuminating leverage on this mind stuff. So that is like that is really basically what Vipassana is about.